This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this tutorial, I'll be explaining how to manually install VCOM drivers on a Windows PC. Now, VCOM driver is very important, especially when you want to use SP Flash 2, because without your VCOM drivers, you can't use SP Flash 2. You usually notice that when you try flashing a file or doing a readback using SP Flash 2 without VCOM drivers, once you switch off your phone and you connect it to the PC, all you see is the phone charging. That means you don't have VCOM drivers. So in this guide, I'll be explaining how to install VCOM drivers manually to enable your phone and SP Flash to communicate effectively. Now, if you're using a Windows 8 PC, you'd want to disable signature verification. I will not be going into that here, but just go to our forum, search for how to disable signature verification on Windows 8 before you can install your VCOM drivers. So the first thing you want to do is to open Device Manager. So I'll search for Device Manager. Alright. In Device Manager, what you'd want to do is click any of these items. Just click any of these items here. Then you click on Action. Then Add Legacy Hardware. Click on Next. You select Install the hardware that I manually select from a list. That is Advanced. And you click Next. Here you just go ahead and click Next. Here you click Have Disk. Now in this box here, you click on Browse, then you go to the VCOM folder here. In this case, now it's basically the same method when you are trying to manually install the driver. All you have to do is locate the .inf file for that driver you are trying to install. But in this case, what we are treating is VCOM driver. If I was treating another driver, all I have to do is go through the entire driver folder, look for a .inf file, and wherever I see that .inf file, which is a setup information file, I just select it in this window here. But in this case, we are installing a VCOM driver, so I know where my .inf file is for the VCOM. I know where the location is for the VCOM INF file, so I just go straight to it. Now in this case, it's in the Mediatek folder, drivers, USB VCOM driver. I'm using the Windows 8, so I want to use the Windows 7. Ensure you select the correct one for your OS here. I select the Windows 7. Now I'm using a 64-bit PC, so I select the one with 64. If you're using a 32, you select 32, but I'm using a 64, so I select the one with the 64 in the name, and I click Open. And then okay, now you'd want to select Mediatek Preloader USB VCOM port in this step, and then you click Next, and then Next, and wait for the driver to finish installing and click Finish. That's that.